this is Ms. Bo-kyum Kim to speak to us about how to treat employees. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Just looking at you, young generation,
today is really happy. How's your manager's meeting?
Good.
Thinking about working as a whole. Just, I want to mention about a little bit before I start. You know, I'm such a lover, you know, in this company. Everybody knows. Sunday I got here, and I went to church with Sue, Tami, Sue, Tami, and some of our friends together. And actually, Sue, Tami, gave to people tests to testimonial? How can I say?
Testimonial.
Yeah. So she talks about me in Korean. After she gave her speech, in my mind, I thought, no matter what happened around Jan and Susadani, or even though she, you know, complained me or she doesn't do anything like that, but even though she kind of pushing me like that, I kind of swear to myself, I will love them forever because not many business owners can do this. So what they gave us is really, really special. I really want you to know about that. So, okay, let's start. Before I give this, prepare this one, I actually texted all my managers and even all my managers. I asked them to, how I treat you, how I mean treat you. So they text me back. Of course, they have to say, you know, good one, right? So their answers are like that. So they said, I'm very motivational, and I respect my managers and employees. I care them, and I'm an understanding person. These are the answers they gave me about me, how I treat them. So thinking about myself, how I did to them. So, I just want to ask you guys, I normally ask this question. Are you a worker, salesperson, or leader, or manager, like somebody mentioned about that? So, being a leader, it has to be really special. So, it has to have a really heart. So you can give your employees a lot. So, let's talk about motivation. I really try to show my all employees to managers, my improvement, and I have to keep moving forward to show them and motivate them. And also, their co-workers, they need to see other people's, our co-workers improve. And the third one, I don't want to ask them their plan, or dreams, or like that kind of stuff, frequently. And if anyone of my employees, they go to school and study more extra effort, I really encourage them, honestly, sincerely. So you can motivate your employees, not only they make more sales, I want you to keep touching their life. Right? That doesn't mean you have to play with them, you have to, you know, go dinner all the time, right? You don't need to be like that. But I want you to keep touching their life and their dream and their plan. They should be really make them change. And here's an example my manager knows. She works at the Mall of America. When I took over the location, she worked there with the former owner, Grace Sadamu. And I can instantly see her. She's such a really, really good person. And she's really hard worker. So I offered her, don't you be a manager? You can do it. And then she answered, oh, I don't want to work too much. And I just want to work like this much, 30 hours or like less than 40 hours. I was kind of a little bit surprised because she needs money, right? So I didn't push her anymore. I just asked her once. After that, I kept talking to her about how we live as a mom and how you can live as a woman and how old are you? What do you want to be like when you get 50 years old? How you would be? That kind of question. I keep asking her. And one day, she kind of, and I was ready. That's it. I just keep throwing her that kind of stuff. And then one day, she asked me to, oh, go, can I be a manager? And I was really like, because that's my job. How many things keep changing and keep improving. I was really, really happy, and now I encourage them and I motivate, try to motivate her. You can do it, that kind of stuff. So she's really working hard. I know she needs a little bit of time to step up, and she has a little bit of moment right now, right? Because she has the short employees. Because Dana and Lo, they work together, and I took her to Naya without him all. That's why she's kind of having a little bit of struggling. But it's okay, I believe, I trust her, she can make it. Right? This is the thing. And one more example, Monica. Actually, when I started work at the Florida Mall as a manager, she was there. And she's the one who taught me hairstyle. And she also kind of quiet. She's not that outgoing. She seems like not that much energetic, but she's always there. She kind of constantly thinking. And she's the one make all the time decisions. Because she never stops. Whatever customer says, she just keeps trying and trying and trying. And she normally makes like big sales. And she also, I keep telling her what you wanna do, and I encourage her when she goes to school. But finally, she also, I didn't offer her. I just keep drawing like that. And then one day she told me that she wants to be a manager. I welcomed her and she became a manager. Because I know she deserved it and she could do that. That kind of stuff, you don't have to really push that. You don't have to really do that kind of stuff. Just keep showing. Keep motivating them. How, make them think about their future. Make them think about how they can improve their life. That's all I can do. That's what I've been doing. And I really respect my employees, but my idea can be a little bit different than other operators. So I don't want to say this is the right answer. This is my style to take care of my business. So I don't want to say this is the right one, but this is what I'm doing. I believe that customer is the best. We have to take care of really, really good. But my idea is I really want to take care really even more than customers. Because running business, as you keep hearing about from yesterday, the lady who is a business owner, keeping employee is the best one. If you have a good employees, they can actually make money for you. So I kind of keep telling all the managers, don't try to work too much and hard. I want you to work really smart. How? As a good leader, and make them work, and you can just keep threatening them. You don't have to really, really work hard and move hard. You just encourage them and make them happy and fun and work. And they just, make money for you operators and to you managers. believe that my employees are more special than, you know, customers. That's what I've been trying to do. And our relationship is really, really good, I believe, because I truly thank them all the time. I really respect them. I really try to care them. So I can feel my employees or managers, they also respect me. And yeah, I feel that all the time. So our communication and our relationship is really good. We are really tight. Because I believe they know my truth, my sincere. This is really hard part. I get so many questions from you guys. Most of managers have a really hard time. How could I keep employees? Sarah Sajami mentioned about this morning. So finding a right person, of course, that's the best one. But in reality, at the mall, some malls, actually, it's easy to hire people, but some malls, you don't even get, you know, resume. It's really tough to hire people, right? So my style is, I don't want to hire a terrible guy who looks like really not good, but we don't really know, at least we try, right? So I kind of try most of employees because I'm a little bit, you know, positive or confident to get them change. So I kind of try most of the girls and then try to make them improve and change depending on their attitude or their everything. I really encourage them and try to change them. But I see so many managers are struggling with this part. How can I treat employees and when they show you guys bad attitude, when they lie to you, and kind of bad stuff. So most of the managers who are really struggling with keeping employees long time, they are very emotional. And sometimes they have a temper. And you know, as you guys see, when I reach at the meeting, everybody looks feeling nice. She looks really good. She's going to be really good at work too. But when you go back to work, I realize that some managers are not good. As I see you at the meeting, everybody seems so nice and gentle and very energetic, very bright. But at work, of course, you get lots of stress. So you kind of it turns out very emotionally, you know, push your employees, and sometimes you hurt them. Of course, running business or having working as a manager, of course, you're going to get lots of hardship with your employees. But your job is get over it. Your job is have to get over that kind of stuff. Right? So I want to show them this kind of stuff a little bit later. And I just want to keep asking you, is there anybody who used to be just a part-time employees in here? Yeah. Anyway, you must have experience, even though not this company, right? So work for someone else. Most of us, we started as a part-time. So I really want you to understand how you feel as an employee. Then you can think about how you need to treat your employees. Because we forget. When you become manager or when you become owner, we sometimes forget how I be treated from them. If you keep in mind how you want to be treated, then you can think about how you need to treat your employees. And yeah, so if you have that kind of a temper, that's terrible. It turns out really, really terribly bad. So I want you to keep in mind that kind of stuff. So this is the one I really want to practice with you. It's kind of real situation at the mall. You're gonna get this kind of situation so many times. Okay? So before I start, This is a Bumi's glasses. I think she has very bad eyes. Is that expensive? Let's see, is it really expensive? Expensive? Okay. Let's see. Chelsea, can you put this one, please? Look at me. How do you like it?
It's hard for me to see.
So, do you like it?
Yeah. I mean, it's okay.
It's very expensive one, so I wish you like to wear every day. Do you want to wear?
No, it's expensive.
But you look like really seems pretty nice. It, the glasses looks good on you. Please wear it every day. you being so nice. It's very expensive. It looks pretty on you. You know, you're gonna love it, okay? Please wear it every day. Let me get this over. How about Jackie, please? Let's see how does it look on you. How do you like it?
I feel blind.
Really? Even though you feel blind, but it looks good on you. How do you? Don't you want to wear this one every day?
Can't see.
Oh, you can see me? Oh my God! I spent a lot of money for this to give you. It's really good for you. How about that?
Thank you.
But you don't want to wear? Oh, that's so sad. Thank you. And how about you, Salagi? Try.
Do you like it?
I
can see. You can see? But it's a really expensive one.
I know, but I can see.
Oh, that's so sad. Yeah. So to someone, this glasses looks really good. Somebody needs that. Really important to women. But even though this one is really expensive and look nice and whatever reason, but to somebody else, it doesn't fit them at all. So this is the concept. Sometimes I say that to some managers. If you used to be good employees, sometimes it's hard. You don't understand, you know, somebody's not good at it, right? So you might think, how come she doesn't do this way? I didn't do that way. I learned so fast. I kind of memorized, you know, colors in 2 hours, but she kind of, you know, memorized like it takes forever. Or I was really good at hair, but she's not good. So I can't wait to, you know, until she's good at it. Or, I used to speak English really, really good. I can't understand that she speaks really terribly. Look at that kind of stuff. So if you used to be really good employee, sometimes it's dangerous to treat your employees. So really, I want to try to understand how their situation is. So if you really try to see their life, because, you know, we really recommend them to dress up really nicely, right? So when they come to work, they have to make up professionally. Of course, that's a requirement. We have to encourage them to do that. But some girls just come to work in terrible outfit sometimes. And they come with a really terrible, you know, almost bare face. So you kind of try to think about, oh, I hate her. I told her so many times, this is company policy. How come she kind of treat me like that way? But she didn't mean to treat you like that. She didn't mean to not respecting you. That's her situation. So what we really need to focus on is when that kind of issue you meet there, what you really need to focus on is how could I make this one change? How could I make this one better? Not thinking about, I hate her. I told her so many times. Even though you don't tell her, but they feel it, how you feel it.